Yes. Then you, obviously, it's always very nice when we are together as colleagues in an organization like Comesa, playing football, developing ourselves. But the objective of doing all those things was to launch us into the new life. And when that comes, painful as it is, people do move and they go into different directions. And that's exactly what we're trying now to say, okay, let's follow up on you guys. So you then took off and everybody else took off in different directions. What direction did you follow and which companies did you go to and what did you attain?
When I was with Sco Metals. Yes, I worked with them, but then I was what they call a sand technician. A sand technician in a metallurgical company. Sco Metals is a metallurgical company that produces wheels. You see the train wheels?
Yes.
Yeah, and the goods, whatever those and the walls are made at Sco Metals, and all the chassis part of a coach are made at the Sco. So my part was to provide the sand and the required chemicals that can be used to make what we call a mold to produce that walls. Yes, from then I was there for quite some time. So when I do this, what we call sand technician, when I look at it, I've had a lot of interaction with different industries within the same circle, the chemical and the metallurgical side. And then by, I'd say, 6 years into it, then I see it as a career, as a thing that I can make a career out of it.
Yes.
So I became what they call it a specialist. I specialized with that. But still with Sco. So Sco was quite a huge company. And then they had the branches. But then they had a branch by Natal. They had a branch in several branches in Johannesburg and some branches in the Cape. So I used to service all those places, and then I became what you call, I'll say, we normally in our industry we call it a sand guru. I became a sand guru.
Wow. So they'll bring all queries to you.
Yes. And then that gave me the opportunity to travel also internationally. Yes, I went to Europe, to Britain, England. I went to Germany. I went to Scotland. And when I went to Europe, the main aim was to develop a technology which can be used to recirculate to recirculate the sand. Like if you use the sand, you buy new sand, you use it, and then also to reuse it again. So South Africa was having a challenge. The challenge of not having what we call, in the industry we call it quality foundry sand.
Yes.
Yeah, so all the reserves, resources, which is mainly by the Cape and some by Mpumalanga and the site of Rustenburg. So everything was being depleted. And the quality needed to be used in the industry was not being found. So the only way out was to try to reuse the quality that you got. So I partook in that research. When I went up there to develop that technology. yeah, we came back, put it into a use, which is still working at school. Mm. But also that and all the learnings that we, one part which came, which was sort of, I'll say something that we learned, I learned when I was still at Comesa, was also to network. That is one biggest thing that Comesa taught us.
Mm.
Yeah, and then which is a skill that I used within the industry to network with the suppliers and also the customers. Mm. So which put me as one of the well-known person within that industry.
Mm. Mm. I remember during the Comesa days with Pelmanism, there was a module on how to make friends. You remember that module?
Yes.
Where we sent you to the park and to say, go and talk to strangers and try to make friends.
Yeah, which also to me was, I was not that very talking person.
Mm.
So I can do the work, I can study, I can play football, I can do, when it comes to go to approaching people and talk to them and whatever, that is one thing which the Comesa helped.
Yeah. Wow.
And it broke that into. Then, yeah, that helped me to also network with the colleagues within the industry.
Yeah. Wow.
And then I began to know a whole lot of people, but also being able, the one part is also, you know people, but there must be something that you can give.
Yes.
And the industry was the knowledge that I got.
Yes.
Which I was able to give. But during that time, also, as I said, I was very much technical focused. Then that need to be changed to leadership.
Mm.
Yeah. Mm. And I also, if you remember, we used to discuss many times when we have COVID, that I said that one day I want to study MBA.
Mm.
Yes, yeah. So also I did study.
So you did. You did end up doing your MBA.
Yeah.
Where did you do it?
With the Milpark Business School.
Which one? Milpark.
Milpark, yeah.
Yes. Wow.
I got it 2012. I started 2010, I think.
So it was also record time. Yes.
I finished it in 2.5.
Yeah. And was the company supporting you there financially with your studies?
Parts. They support parts. Part they had to pay.
Yes. Wow. Wonderful. Wow. And that must be helping now in your current situation, that MBA.
Yes. It's helping a lot.
Hmm.
You won't take away the, because the one part, like I said, the Comesa help us with networking, and that becomes something that's sort of like something that breaks all the barriers as you go.
Mm.
Something that stays with you that doesn't go away.
Mm. Mm. Wow.
Which will get all the other learnings, MBA and stuff, but then still.
Mm.
You still need that part of the that character, that part of thing, which is still there.
Yeah,
working.
So how long were you with Score Metal?
I went with Score until last year. I worked with them for 18 years.
Wow.
I've been there for a long time. Then I, last year, October, it has been on my mind long time, but I'll say the past 5 years.
Mm.
Yeah, what I found out now, most of the things in the industry I know.
Yes.
And then there is problems in different places, which some you cannot be able to help because you're restricted, because you belong to a certain organization, and those organizations are doing the same thing.
Mm.
So you cannot be able to help them. And then which pushed me to as a consultant, to founder consultant.
Yes.
Yeah. Then I decided last year by October that I need to go full time as a consultant, founder consultant, which I am doing. But I'm doing it under an organization called Nalevi Investment Holding.
What do they call it?
Nalevi Investment Holding.
Are you a partner there?
Yes.
Wow. And who your partner is from where?
With the other guy is from, we studied together when we were at that secondary school that I spoke about.
Oh, yes.
Yes, yeah. And then his name is Rachivumo Matozo. Yeah, and then his specialty is information technology. So I bring in the mining specialist.
Wow.
Yeah, that's the line that I push. I consult under those that sector and everything that has to do with the mining and the foundries.
And business is good, Toman?
Yeah, the business is good. And we do offer, one part is consulting and also offering as a supplier too. And then we do send, foundry send, and then foundry send it in terms of we do sell send to companies, and then we also do recycling waste. For instance, if it's a foundry, the foundry generate a lot of waste in terms of the used sand, in terms of the other material that they use. So we help in removing that waste and take it to where that waste can be incinerated or it can be recycled.
Wonderful. This is brilliant. So I was talking to Ndateki Vitin Chumayelo in another interview, and we spoke about the German system of what they call a Wirtschaft Ingenieur, which is a combination of engineering and economics. When I look at what you did, having studied engineering and then specialized in the sand, you went and studied MBA, and as a result, basically, you then brought the economics or business management into your engineering. I guess that is a winning formula, right?
That's a very much winning formula, because with your engineering, yes, you understand the concept, technical concept, and then with your economic side, you are able to convert that technical knowledge into something that can generate income. Yeah, which is basically what is happening.
Wonderful. That's beautiful. And to start to have a partnership with your childhood schoolmate, isn't that wonderful?
It's wonderful. In the sense that you, when things are not, but you share a lot of memories.
Yes. And where's your office, Toman?
So the company is based in Randburg, Olivedale.
Yes. Yeah. And this is a great story, and I am really grateful that we did this, because you've really reached, it looks like you've really arrived at something that is really, that's what you love doing. And I think before we finish the talk, it will be good to share your contact details of your company with people so that they can really be able to reach you. I mean, this is a great story. But you did indicate that you're also doing farming.
Yes, yeah. So what happened by, I'll say 2012, 2013?
Yes.
I purchased land somewhere next to Carnival City.
Yes.
They call it Vedhok Estate. It's a plot, which is, by then it was a 4.5 hectare plot, which it was not really working. We're using it as a church. By the way, I also studied a degree in ministry, theological degree. When I was doing my MBA, I was at the same time doing my theological degree.
Wow.
Which
college did you go to?
Impact University.
Wow. So, and you finished it. So, are you still running your ministry now?
Not full-time. I was running it full-time from 2012 to 2019. Then I gave it to someone who was helping. And now I'm on a supporting role.
But how did it come? Did you get a calling at night, or how did it happen that you decided to become a minister of a church?
we call it a call.
Yes.
So, what happened was I used to go to Rema Church.
Yes.
And also used to listen a lot to people who were preaching.
Yes.
And also that edge when I was still at Comesa, the question which always keep coming, who are you? really do you stand for? What is it that you want to do in this life? Keep on circulating until when I join the church and start to understand what is it that, what about God and all those things. And then it came, now. You need to help people.
Yes.
Yeah, you must teach. But also, yes, you're going to go stand and teach. But also, you need to know what you're teaching, which also prompted me that now I need also to be, to mix
yes.
with people who have walked that path. And the way for me to mix with them was to attend that university and do my theology.
Yes.
And I finished. I started with 2009.
Yes.
And by 2011, I completed it. And the next year, I was completing my MBA.
Wow.
It was 2009 to 2012, which was very, 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 very busy.
But I can imagine the energy in that theological class. You didn't just do it because of qualification. You are responding to a call, calling.
I was responding to a call.
It must have been very energizing.
Yeah, because by then you want to know. It's full of questions.
Yes.
You ask a lot. You participate a lot. It's not something that you're doing because somebody is pushing you. Not something that you're doing because you want to satisfy another person. It's something that is coming from within. So you
tell me, Toman, has that question that started at Comesa being answered? Who are you?
Yeah, it is answered. Yes. It has been answered.
Is it?
And then, yes, which I will, which also something that I can share is what then happened as you, it's like also if you teach the word of God to other people, as you teach, also the Spirit of God is also talking to you.
Yes.
Yeah, which as it goes, what then God revealed to me is he called me to steward
yes.
his businesses. And his businesses are the business that I will be doing, my consulting, my farming, and then at the same time, but it's a steward with the aim of reaping back to the community.
Yes.
So whatever profit that you make, part of that profit needs to assist again in the kingdom of God.
Wow.
To assist also to grow other people, to develop people.
Wow.
So, which answered in the sense of it takes away the selfish part of me. That whatever you bring is not for your family. Whatever you bring is not for you to go buy the next car that comes out, the next Mercedes-Benz or the next BMW. But no, it is to grow other people.
Wow.
So whatever you do, whatever I do, whatever I achieve, whatever I'm doing, so whatever thing that comes, develop other people.
Beautiful. Beautiful. We must say amen to that. I mean, this is beautiful story. And now, Tomane, how do people get a hold of you? Number one, read the type of a consulting work that you do, because it does sound like Sense Specialist is a very unique service in the foundries that you do. But also then farming, what are you farming? Yes.
And then with those vegetables, specifically spinach.
Yes.
What we call kale.
Yes.
Which is a rape and what they call chumolia.
Mm-hmm.
And mustard. Mustard, normally many people from the north, they call it China.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Wow. And do you supply distributors, or you people buy directly from you?
People buy direct, and also I do supply. Some I supply okay. Some I supply Food Lovers Market.
Yes.
And then majority I take to the City Deep Market and the Springs Market. As we're talking now, I was just from delivering vegetable to the City Deep Market.
Wow, this is a great story. This is. I'm just happy that you're doing something that you love, and you have served your term in corporate. Now you are really, as you say, you are doing something to feed the nation, spiritually, physically as well.
Yes.
Yeah. Wow. Tomane, I'm going to give you the opportunity to really take your time to share your contact details with those who want to buy your veggies, those who want to get you for your consulting work in foundry. And I don't know whether you are on social media. I don't know whether there is one contact for all these businesses, but either way, and if you have websites as well, people can follow up on you.
Yeah, yes, I'm going to start with the farming. With the farming, the company name is called Dion Agri Holding.
Yes.
Dion Agricultural Holding. It is based in Trappan, Vedhog Estate. The physical address is the 221 Man Street in Vedhog Estate.
Spell the street name.
It's Mans, M-A-N.
Oh.
Man Street.
Yes.
Yeah, in Vedhog, Trappan.
Yeah. And then you said the name of the farming is what? Is it the vendor name, it sounds like?
Yes, it's Ndione.
Oh, which means it is the one.
It is the one, yes.
Ndione.
Agricultural Holding.
Yes. And the telephone number?
It's 084-519-3442. And then the landline is 011-827-2351.
Yes.
And then also on the contact on the email is, it's quite a long one, is Tomane, which is my name and my surname, Mohanganei.
Yes.
number3@gmail.com.
I'm going to ask you to spell it, because those who don't know the Venek, they may not get it right. So just spell it from, is it one way, tomanemuhangane@gmail.com?
Yeah, it's Tomane, which is TomaneMuhangaNei, and then number3@gmail.com.
Wonderful. There's another friend of ours that we hosted here at Commerza Club Radio Africa, Mr. Simon Mhlala, based in the Vaal. He's also doing farming, and I think you guys can have some interesting synergy there. I'm very excited that so many of our friends and former members are seeming to be developing love for farming. That's giving hope for the countrymen.
Yes,
absolutely.
We need food, yes.
Tomane.
That's one The other thing that I forgot is under the same Leon. Leon is like the umbrella name. Then you got Leon Agricultural Holding.
Yes.
Then you also got Leon Fencing. I'm also in fencing.
Fencing.
So fencing, yeah. So we do clear view fencing, and then we do the concrete slabs.
Yes.
Like the concrete palisade.
Yes.
Yeah, and also we do all types of fencing.
Mm. Oh, fencing, yes.
Fencing, yes.
Yeah.
And then we manufacture slabs.
Yes.
You see, if you remember when you were starting Cometa, you still remember your fence.
Yes.
Your fence at home.
Yes.
Those slabs.
Yes.
So, yeah, I got a company that manufactured those slabs.
Wow. Where is it based?
It's based here also in Brakpan.
Yeah. So Brakpan has become your headquarters and your home, ne?
Yeah, it's more of a business headquarters.
When are you opening the branch in Venda?
Well, we're still working on that. What we currently do is we do most of the work at Limpopo, around that side of Lebowahomo towards Pietersburg.
Yes.
And also straight at Venda.
Yes.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
So we're working on that.
And then you have big plans for Indeone.
Very big plans, yes. But Indeone on the other side is more on the manufacturing. Then you've got the softer one, which is the Nairobi Investment Holding.
Yes.
Which is, that is very much on consulting. One part I said that we do consulting on sand, foundry, it's on sand, but normally on the if you go in the web, you'll find it, if you go online, normally you'll find it as a general foundry consulting, which normally do some of the things maybe you won't understand.
Yeah.
We do refractories.
Mm.
We do resins.
Mm-hmm.
We do all the acid, organic acids that are used to manufacture those castings.
Yes.
And also the physical know-how on how to run a foundry sand plant, how to run foundry sand plants, and how to run foundry and laboratories.
Wow, this is beautiful story. And the contact details for the consulting site
is the cell phone is still 084-519-3442, and then also the landline is still 011-827-2351. And then online, the web is www.narivinvestment.co.za.
Just spell it.
Narivi is NARIVZI.
Okay.
And then investment holding.
Yeah. Wonderful, wonderful. In any event, if people haven't got the details proper and they want to get a hold of you, they could also come to us and we'll definitely connect them with you, Tomane. We are very proud of this great achievement. We are clear that in a small way, Cometa could be part of your journey. And this is the whole idea. Thank you very much for being generous with this information. It was not just information, by the way, it's also very educational. The content is very rich. Your journey is inspiration to so many people. And we would love to be of help in connecting you with those who might have been touched by your session with me. Any last remarks?
Yeah, the last remarks is also, I forgot to admit also, the people, if they want to also purchase properties, I'm also in real estate.
Yes.
Through my wife in a company called Helena Real Estate.
Yes.
So we sell properties.
Yes.
Around the East End.
Yeah.
Yeah, but also if you are on the West End or whatever side, we can assist them with all the legalities.
Wonderful.
That are needed, or if you have any problems with the property purchasing or with anything happening with the property.
Yes.
Feel free to contact us.
Yes.
And also offer that service.
Is that using the same contact details?
Yes.
Yeah. As I said, we will definitely, probably some will contact us because it's quite a lot to remember, but I'm sure the office will link them with you. And thank you for giving that full scope of what you are involved in. If you had told me then, when you were at Comesa, that one day you're going to be a serial entrepreneur, I would have not believed it. You have really done it. And I think what works for you is the focus and the discipline and the hard work, Tomani. It's not only about the ability to learn, but it's also all those characters. Thank you very much. It has been wonderful. I've learned so much from you. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Tomani Muhangane, one of the pioneers that started the journey at Comesa. And you have heard all what he does. Feel free to get hold of him. If you have missed the contact, get hold of us at Comesa Club Radio Africa. You know how to get hold of us in terms of the streaming. It's www.comesaclubradio.africa. Otherwise, if you are keen to be a member of Comesa Friends and Supporters Club, NPO, you go to www.comesaclub.africa, and under membership, you follow the process online. You could become part of us. I'm Sam Zima. I'm the CEO at Comesa GOC International, and I'm also an executive business coach. It has been a pleasure being with Tomani Muhangane. I hope you enjoyed it. We look forward to receiving you at the next broadcast. Goodbye.